Last year, one of our most recognisable and popular comedians revealed he had stage 4 cancer. His 3-year secret was now public. Since then, Dai Henwood has embraced his diagnosis, written a book, The Life of Dai, and he's kept making people laugh. He joins us now. Congratulations on writing a book.
Oh, ata maria, Chris. And no, it's something I didn't think I'd ever have in me. I must say, my life has been talking rubbish and moving on, usually as a comedian. And going into something that was so personal for me, it's sort of an autobiographical part to it, which is my early years as a comedian and so forth, and then my cancer diagnosis and how I'm sort of trying to live positively through adversity. I wanted to have tips in there for people, and it's quite an undertaking, and I'm very proud it's out now.
I mean, I take it you were writing this with Jackie Brown while you were undergoing treatment. That must have been exhausting.
Yes, like it mentions in there that I was up to my 20th round of chemo. I was still doing chemo while I was collaboratively putting the book together with her. We did sort of heaps of interviews. I found it easier just to chat while I was doing treatment. And then she put it together, and then I had my sort of go on it. We went back and forth, and it was pretty tough because I was feeling rubbish. I was bringing up going through 3 years. I've had 6 major surgeries. I've had countless rounds of radiation and chemo, and since the book I've had 6 more rounds of chemo, and I'm still managing to keep a smile on my face, and I really want this book to act as awareness for people, tips for people who are going through cancer or who have loved ones who are going through cancer, and also to show that you've got to live. Now, I'm not dying with cancer, I'm living with cancer.
I was going to bring up that phrase because I know a big part of this book is about you reframing your own narrative, right? You're not dying of cancer, you're living with it. It's not terminal, it's incurable. How big of a thing is for you to... I mean, you've written a book, but you've kind of become the author of your own story in so many other ways by actually reframing how you look at life.
Yeah, well, I was walking out of this building here. I'd filmed a episode of Have You Been Paying Attention, a wonderful show we did on TVNZ, and that's when I got the call that it was incurable. And being told that is huge. I'd had 3 years of we've got this intent to cure, but then I realised it's incurable by the Western means we have at hand. Things are popping up. You know, I look at myself as a classic car that I've just got to keep on the road with a bit of spot welding here and there until we come up with a way to beat this thing, or whether my body finally goes, come on, get out of here.
Yeah. I mean, how do you feel at the moment? You look amazing.
Oh, thanks. This has been a blessing and a curse. I've looked pretty similar through all my treatment, which has been wonderful. For my whānau and kids, it hasn't been too confronting. I feel great. I still have sort of... So I've got bowel cancer, but it's only in my lungs and my sort of lymphs around my chest. So I have a few breathing things. I'll probably be doing radiation in a couple of weeks, but right now I'm not in treatment and I've got a smile on my face, and I'm so proud of this book as well.
Your kids, when you first started going through this, were obviously 3-4 years younger. They kind of get into that age now where they're going to be probably understanding a bit more about what's going on. How do you deal with that?
It's interesting because to an adult, the word cancer carries so much weight. We've got every TV show, every whānau member, every friend of a friend. You've got all that weight to it. To a kid, it's just a word. They don't have that yet. So I'm... I'm just being open with them. I don't overwhelm them with information. I tell them the bare bones and I wait for questions. And often the question is, can we go get McDonald's? they're not actually too dialed in on it. So my thing is being open and honest, but then answering anything honestly with them and sharing them. And the hardest thing I must say is when you have a broken arm, when you have a cold, you're in... immediately want to go, it's going to be fine. So you've got to navigate that conversation without saying it's going to be fine, because I never want to lie to my children.
Can I just say that the interview you did with Jackie Brown last year, watching that, I just thought you are just the personification of grace. I mean, we all know people that have gone through cancer, and I just feel emotional talking about it, but you are so gracious, and your book is just the continuation of that. And I mean, we've never met before, but after watching that interview, I was like, I'm on your side, you know?
Oh, thanks, Chris.
And I think, like, New Zealanders think that as well about you. They're just behind you and rooting for you. And, yeah, I wish you every success with the book, of course, and with life. Where can people find this?
So the thing is, it's going to be in shops in a couple of days. People can go to laughwithdai.com. Mm-hmm. That's where you can pre-order the book. If my cancer journey is not your thing and you just want straight up laughs, I've also got a
there's comedy.
Got a big stand-up show, Die Hard, that I'm doing in Otatahi, Christchurch, and Tamaki Makaurau, Auckland, over the next couple of months, which is a bit of cancer stuff, but it's just straight up laughs. So laughwithdai.com for all your Dai Henwood needs.
Dai Henwood, you are a legend. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks, Chris. And thank you for writing this book and giving us all a greater understanding of what it's like to live with cancer, and for doing it with such humility, some humour in there, and also some grace, my friend. Thank you.
Kia ora.